would say that we are deeply concerned at the many numerous and credible reports that we've received that in the name of combating religious extremism and maintaining social stability, the state party has turned the Uyghur autonomous region into something that resembles a massive internment camp that is shrouded in secrecy, a sort of a no rights zone, and that members of the Uyghur minority, along with others who are identified as Muslims, are being treated as enemies of the state based solely on their ethno-religious identity. There are reports of mass detentions of ethnic Uyghurs and other Turkic Muslim minorities. There are estimates that upwards of 1 million people are being held in so-called counter-extremism centers, and another 2 million have been forced into so-called re-education camps for political and cultural indoctrination. Others are under a form of house arrest. These detainees are almost all from the Uyghur minority group or other targeted minorities. Others may have traveled outside the country or have relatives who have done so. All of these detainees have had their due process rights violated. Most have never been charged with an offense, tried in a court of law, or afforded an opportunity to challenge the illegality of their detention. Many just disappear. Their relatives never know what happened to them. Reports indicate that the state party is making even the most commonplace expressions of ethno-religious significance to Muslims into penal offenses, such as daily greetings, possession of certain halal products, wearing a long beard or a full face headscarf, and refusal to watch state television. All of these have at times apparently been grounds for detention. There are reports of mass surveillance disproportionately targeting ethnic Uyghurs, including those frequent stops by police and mobile scanning of phones at checkpoints. It is reported that in the Uyghur Autonomous Region, the state party also imposes mandatory collection of extensive biometric data, including DNA samples and iris scans of all residents between the ages of 12 and 65. Reports also indicate that all residents of the region are required to hand in their travel documents and then apply for permission to leave the country, and that permission may not come for years. And this has particular impact on those who wish to travel for religious purposes. Recent amendments to the legal framework appear designed to enable even greater control over the Uyghur minority and other minority groups. I refer to the criminal law amendments, the national security law, the counterterrorism law, the cybersecurity law, and the religious affairs regulations law. These new amendments to the legal framework, among other problems, establish imprecise and overbroad definitions of national security offenses, including offenses related to terrorism and extremism that enable abusive, arbitrary, and discriminatory prosecutions and convictions.